Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 6.2 that is taken from chapter number 6, Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is draw the shear and moment diagram for the beam shown in figure 6-5A. So you can see this is a cantilever beam having fixed support at the end, and there is a linear bearing load, or you can say triangular load of magnitude W naught over the entire length L. So you have to determine the shear and moment diagram for the beam. So let's start with the solution. The first step is that if you remove this fixed support at the end, so you will be having a reaction force. Let this reaction force is R, and when you remove this, there will be a moment as well, M, and there will be a normal load as well. Okay, so this will be equal to N. So we'll find first this R, N, and M. These are reaction loadings. So by using the equation of equilibrium, so first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to zero, and force toward right is taken as positive. So only N is acting. There is no other force. So it means N is equal to zero. Now, the another equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero, and upward force is taken as positive. So R, which is acting upward, so I can write R, and you can see there is a triangular load of magnitude W naught. So if you convert this distributed load into a point load, so I can write, since this is a triangular, so its magnitude will be equal to 1 over 2 W naught, and multiply by the length over which it acts. And this will act at a distance of 2L by 3 from this fixed end. This is 2L by 3. And from this free end, this will be equal to L by 3. Okay. So from here, you can see R is acting upward, so it is positive, minus this load which is acting upward downwards, so their sum must be equal to zero. So minus 1 over 2 W naught into L is equal to zero. So from here you will get this R will be equal to 1 over 2 W naught multiplied by length. And the last thing that we will determine over here is this moment. So for that I will apply the sum of all moment is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So if I designate this as point O, so can write it sum of all moment about point O is equal to zero. So first moment is this one. You can see this is counterclockwise moment. It is taken as positive. So M, the second moment is produced due to this load, which is 1 over 2 W naught into L, and perpendicular distance is 2L by 3. And this is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So I can write minus 1 over 2 W naught into L into 2L by 3 is equal to 0. So moment minus, it will be equal to W naught L square over 3 is equal to 0. So from this we will get this moment will be equal to W naught L square over 3. Now you have this moment, so what we will do is that we will find the equation for shear force and bending moment diagram. So again, if you cut it at any length, if I cut it at this length, and let this distance is X, so you can see for the entire length this is W naught. So what will be the magnitude? Let this will be W. So if I take the ratio, since we have two triangle, one is this one and another one is this one, both are similar triangle, so the ratio of their side will be equal. So if I take W naught divided by L, let me write it W naught over L, that will be equal to this W over length X. So from this we will get this W will be equal to W naught into X by L. So I can write it as W naught X by L. So if I cut it over a length of X and draw the free body diagram, so let me draw it first. That this is the beam. Here you have a reaction force, which is W naught L by 2. And you have a moment, which is W naught L square over 3. And there is a uniformly increasing load. The length of this beam where we have cut this is X. And this X is greater or equal to 0 and less or equal to L. Clear? And the magnitude over here is W, which was equal to W naught into X divided by L. Now what we will do is that if you cut the beam at any distance of length L, so you will be having a shear force, which is represented as V, and you will have a moment M. And we will find this shear force and moment by using equation of equilibrium. Remember that this is a uniformly increasing load. So when this load is converted into a point load, so I can convert it by using formula 1 over 2, its magnitude, which is W naught X over L, and the length over which it acts, which is equal to X. Clear? And that will act at a distance of X by 3 from this end. While from this end, this distance will be equal to 2X by 3. Okay. Now we'll apply equation of equilibrium. That first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along Y direction must be equal to 0 and upward force is taken as positive. Okay. So what you will get is that this V, which is acting downward, which is shear force, so minus V plus this reaction force, which is W naught L by 2, and this upward force, this also downward force, minus 1 over 2 W naught X square over L will be equal to 0. Okay, so from this we will get this shear force will be equal to W naught L by 2 minus 1 over 2 W naught X square over L. And if you think you see that the term W naught over 2L, this is W naught L over 2. Let me check. So we are taking W naught L, W naught over 2L common. So I will have here L square minus X square. Okay. So when you multiply this with this term, you can see it will give you W naught L over 2. And when you multiply this term, this term with this, so it will give you the same term, minus W naught X square over 2L. So this is the shear force equation, and we will designate this equation as equation number 1. That will show you the behavior of shear force along the length L. Now we'll find this moment by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about point 1 is equal to 0 and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So let this is your point 1. Okay, now the first moment about point 1 is this one, which is counterclockwise, so it will be positive. The second moment will be this force multiply by perpendicular distance. This is also creating counterclockwise moment. It will be positive. And the third one is this W naught into L, and perpendicular distance is X. This is clockwise, so it will be negative. And this positive W naught L cube, L square over cube will be equal to 0. So I will take it from this side. So first moment is W naught L square over 3. Clear? The second moment will be due to this load, which is producing clockwise moment. So minus W naught L over 2 into perpendicular distance X. The third one is due to this load. So that will be equal to plus 1 over 2 W naught x square over L into perpendicular distance is x by 3 plus this m is equal to 0. Okay, so when you solve it, you will get this moment will be equal to W naught L x over 2 minus W naught L square over 3 minus W naught x cube over 6 L is equal to this moment. If you take W naught over 6 L common from this, so you will get it minus 2 L cube from this term. Clear? Minus from this term you will get minus x cube plus 3L square x. If you rearrange it, you will get moment will be equal to W naught over 6L into minus 2L cube plus 3L square x minus x cube. And this is your moment equation. Now you have both shear force and moment equation, so you can just draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. For that, I will draw two lines from the end of this. If I draw a vertical line from the end of this cantilever beam, and first we will draw the shear force. So on y-axis you will have shear force, and along the length of beam we will take this x. Clear? So put x is equal to 0 in equation number 1. So when you put x is equal to 0 in this equation, so you can see it will be equal to v will be equal to w naught l square over 2l, and that will be equal to w naught l over 2. And again you can see at the end you have w naught l over 2 plus, so plus means it is upward. So if I plot it on this shear force diagram, so let this is your point. For example, this is your W naught L over 2. Now for X is put X is equal to L in equation number 1. So you can see this x will be replaced with L, so L square minus L square will be 0. So 0 multiplied by W naught over 2 L will be equal to 0. So shear force is equal to 0. So it means that at this end your shear force is 0. Now you can see that this loading is uniformly increasing load, and this line is a linear line. So your shear force will be a second degree curve, and it will be like this, and it will be in clockwise direction. Okay, so this is your shear force diagram. Now we'll move toward the bending moment diagram. For that, I will draw a horizontal line, and x will show the length, and on y-axis you have bending moment. Now put x is equal to 0 in equation number 2. So when you put it in this equation number 2, so you will get moment will be equal to minus W naught L square over 3. And you can confirm it. You can see that here this is W naught L square over 3, but that is counterclockwise. And remember that while drawing counterclockwise moment on bending moment diagram, this counterclockwise moment will cause toward downward, towards the negative, because it is convention and given in the book. So we'll plot this at x is equal to 0. Let this moment is like this. At this point it is minus W naught L square over 3. Okay, and when you put x is equal to L in equation number 2, so you can see that this x, this term will be 0, this term will be 0, and we will left with moment will be equal to put x is equal to L. So if I put it over here, so it will be W naught over 6L minus 2L cube plus 3L cube minus L cube. Clear? So 3L cube minus L cube will give you 2L cube plus and minus 2L cube will bring this term as 0. Clear? So from here you will get this moment will be equal to 0. So moment at the end when x is equal to L, it will be 0. And you can see that this shear force diagram is like this. This is in clockwise. So this will be also in clockwise and it will be a third degree curve. So I will draw it like this. So this is your bending moment diagram. Again, if you want to find the value at any length, so just put the value of x in this equation or in equation of moment. Clear? So you will get the required value of shear force and bending moment diagram at that point. Also, you can confirm this shear force equation and bending moment equation, whether you have done it or not, that is explained in this example. And that was all about this example 6.2. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.